pray, should I go upper row? Should I go up, or should people from the first row?
Thank you. Please remain standing for our national anthem. You may be seated. Good evening. As superintendent of the Warrensburg R6 School District, I'm honored to welcome you to the Warrensburg High School commencement ceremonies for the graduating class of 2022. We are here to celebrate the accomplishment of these 208 seniors. As you arrived this evening, you heard the outstanding musical selections performed by the Warrensburg High School Band. The band has earned a reputation for excellence. Please join me in expressing our appreciation to the Warrensburg High School Band. Thank you. On behalf of the Warrensburg R6 School District, I would also like to thank the University of Central Missouri for their cooperation and assistance in allowing us to hold the graduation ceremonies here. We greatly appreciate our partnership and the strong relationship with the university. Please join me in thanking Dr. Roger Best and the University of Central Missouri. Thank you. An event like this can only take place with the support and effort of many individuals. Please allow me to recognize a few of our honored guests on the stage this evening. On the front row, to my left, Mr. Glenn Glogley. He is a counselor. Next to him, we have Dr. Scott Chenault, board president. Mr. Jerry Krause, counselor, and our faculty speaker this evening. Dr. Brett Pummel, principal. Mrs. Sarah Chapman, assistant principal. Dr. Holly Jennings, assistant principal. Mrs. Kelly Nemo, counselor. On the second row, we have Mr. Justin Johnson, board member. Dr. Shannon Bridgman, board member. Mr. Gary Grigsby, board treasurer. Dr. John Finan, assistant superintendent. Dr. Troy Marnholtz, assistant superintendent, Mr. Matt Sargent, board vice president, and Mr. Tom McCormick, board member. Thank you. I want to take this opportunity to recognize the faculty and staff of Warrensburg R6 School District. Many of them are with us this evening. The graduation of a student is a culmination of efforts of all our staff members. These efforts begin at the moment the student enters preschool or kindergarten and continues to this very evening. At this time, I would like for every faculty and staff member here to stand and let us recognize you. Thank you. A strong high school program is not possible without outstanding leadership. Please join me in welcoming the 2022 Missouri Association of Secondary Schools Principals West Central Principal of the Year, our very own Warrensburg High School Principal, Dr. Brett Pummel.
Thank you, Dr. Cole. These past few years have shown us the importance of celebrating our milestone achievements that we often take for granted. High school graduation is certainly one of life's most memorable events, and we hope we never take this moment for granted again. The express purpose of this ceremony is to recognize these students who have successfully completed the program of studies required by our school district to receive a high school diploma from Warrensburg High School. Graduates, 4 years ago on Freshman Transition Day, I was blessed to welcome you on your first day as a class at Warrensburg High School. And now it's an honor for me to stand with you, shake your hands as you come across the stage on the last night you will be together as the class of 2022. Little did I know that day that I would be addressing a first in our school's history, our doubles tennis team, as state champions as of a few hours ago, Jack and Sam Renfro. You'll hear from Jack a little later on. We were a little nervous he might not make it back. I want to express a special welcome to parents, family members, and guardians of the members of this senior class. Graduates, it's your turn to flip the script. Would you please join me in recognizing your family members supporting you here tonight? I would also like to acknowledge all the alumni of Warrensburg High School. If you're in this illustrious group, please stand and be recognized. I also want to take this opportunity to express my personal appreciation to the faculty and staff of the Warrensburg Area Career Center, Reese Education Center, and especially Warrensburg High School. Without your collective guidance and tutelage, these students would not be here tonight. The last few years have shown us the importance of the teacher in the front of the classroom, and I have watched in amazement of your grace, flexibility, and willingness to find new ways to engage and inspire students so that they have the tools to succeed in all of their future endeavors. You make this principal extremely proud. We've identified many individuals who helped make this event possible. However, I know there are others who have not been acknowledged. Students, there are many people who made certain you had the opportunity to be here this evening. You took the opportunities provided, you worked hard, you earned this diploma. Please do not forget to thank your family, teachers, friends, and others who have supported and encouraged you along the way. Many of these people are here tonight, however, others are not. We have an empty chair in front of you holding a place for a missed classmate. Please join me in a moment of silent reflection and appreciation for those missing from tonight's celebration. Thank you. Later in the program, the names of each senior will be read as they cross the stage. We ask that everyone in attendance here tonight be mindful of the importance of this ceremony and give it the respect it deserves. Each and every student and his or her family deserve our respect and attention. In consideration of this, we respectfully make the following request to those in attendance. Please remain seated so those around you can observe the ceremony. Noisemakers such as air horns are not appropriate during the ceremony and should not be used. It's disruptive and, quite frankly, disrespectful of the ceremony. Please refrain from using noisemakers until the ceremony is complete. Please listen attentively so those around you can also hear. On behalf of the administration, school board, faculty, staff, and most importantly, these 208 students, I ask you to help make this a dignified, memorable ceremony. Thank you for your consideration.
just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Well, that's a special treat. The vocal music room is just outside my office. I get to hear that every day, all day, and it never gets old. At this time, it's with great honor that I introduce our faculty speaker for this evening, Mr. Jerry Krause. Mr. Krause graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in Economics from Bridgewater College in 1979, a Master's in Divinity from Bethany Theological Seminary in 1987, and a Master of Science in Counseling from the University of Central Missouri in 2006. Mr. Krause has served as a WHS counselor for the past 12 years and consistently encourages our students to achieve their dreams. He and his wife, Becky, a WHS alum, have been blessed with three children, all WHS alumni, and during his lifetime, he has lived in four different countries, Ecuador, Northern Ireland, the Dominican Republic, and the United States, which has enabled him to develop a deep respect for all people of various cultures, creeds, and ethnicities. While this is his last graduation with us due to his well-deserved retirement, I have no doubt that he won't be far from our minds as we try to do what he has always taught us, simply keep trying to make the world a better place for everyone. Will you please help me welcome Mr. Jerry Krause.
Parents, family, friends, Warrensburg R6 school board members, staff, faculty, and members of the WHS Class of 2022. I'm honored to speak on this special occasion. In August of 2010, the majority of you began your school year in the first grade. That was the same month that I began in my role as one of the counselors at Warrensburg High School. At that time, as I set up my email account, I chose a brief phrase to accompany my signature on every email: to prepare and equip knowledgeable, responsible world citizens. I think that is the mission we parents, guardians, teachers, and school staff have shared as providers of your education and support during your elementary, middle, and high school careers. We've tried to help prepare you and equip you to be knowledgeable, responsible members of the global community. Here we are, 12 years after you began the first grade. In January, I sent you an email inviting you to tell me what you've learned that will help you be a knowledgeable, responsible world citizen. Several of you responded. What I heard in each of your responses was that you've learned that being such a person involves the attitudes that you choose to have and the actions that you choose to take each day. Here is some of what you told me. Emma Smith said, "Too high of expectations are not a thing when it comes to what you want in life. Do what makes you smile, laugh, and never settle." Thinking of all the teams he has been on, Tyler Ward said, "Being on a team teaches you a lot. Working together, caring for each other, and holding each other accountable." Trinity Miller said, "I've learned that taking the easy way out is not the best way. Working hard and putting time and effort into everything you do will help you succeed." Yuming Wu said, "The most important thing I've learned in high school is to expand my perspectives. I've come to find that life becomes more interesting when I push the boundaries a bit and get out of my comfort zone." Several of you highlighted the importance of kindness. Nathan Stevens said, "I've learned to be kind and courteous to others and to never really be mean or rude to someone." Gavin Fontaine said, "My experiences taught me that the most powerful tool in life is friendship and being kind and courteous to others. I learned this from my own challenges I faced. There were many times when someone's random act of kindness helped me in ways that person would never know." Abigail Richner said, "I've learned that a little grace goes a long way and that growth is always possible." Elena Gumatautau said, "I've learned to take learning into the real world, to challenge ignorance and intolerance, and to get involved in local, national, and global communities." Sophia Rodriguez said, "During my time at Warrensburg High School, I've learned to be patient with COVID. It was hard and stressful, but all the teachers that I had were amazing." Kiefer Meiske said, "Nothing will ever be normal, but with every change comes a learning opportunity and ways to advance and make progress." Reese Patterson said, "I personally learned that nothing is permanent. So enjoy things while they last, but let go when they're gone. Go and do things while you can before your time is up. focus on what is happening now rather than looking far into the future. Class of 2022, your learning is an inspiration and an encouragement for each of us. As you begin a new chapter in your lives, take heart in knowing that human beings around the world are with us on this journey towards becoming more knowledgeable, responsible neighbors to one another. It is a daily journey in which we will continue to face new opportunities and unexpected challenges. It is a journey during which we each must choose the attitudes to have, and we must choose the actions to take. Anya Dombrowska, one of our longtime family friends who is a resident of Warsaw, Poland, shared a video with us a couple of months ago. I will close with this story told on a TikTok video by a citizen from Poland in early March, a few weeks after the Russian invasion of Ukraine. The Polish man said this in his video: "I want to say something from the bottom of my heart. I've spent the last 2 or 3 weeks watching what I think is one of the most extraordinary stories of this century being written in front of our eyes. It is the story of the nation of Poland, how it mobilized and came together to help 1.4 million refugees. Within a week or two after the war began, these refugees began flooding across the border into Poland. Not long after, the first cries went out. Where are the camps? Where are all these people? Where have they gone if there are so many refugees? They were in Polish homes. Polish private citizens picked them up from the border, acting completely organically. There was no coordination. They just drove there. They didn't know what they were driving towards, but they drove there. They went towards the danger, towards the fire, towards the light. And they picked up these total strangers, and they brought them. They called on their phones. They messaged saying, "Hey, I've got this flat apartment. I need someone to pick up this family of six. Oh, and they have a dog." And somehow these amazing networks spread up mostly on social media. But not only that, strangers work with strangers to help complete strangers to find them a home and shelter. This man continued his story saying, "I have been fortunate enough to be one of those people. We welcomed a Ukrainian family who we basically had no idea who they were into our home. And already by the next morning, my daughter said, 'Dad, I think I love Babushka, the grandma.' He said, 'And when I hugged them goodbye, I was honestly bereft because I was going to miss them.' And he concludes, 'Within less than a day, I felt like I'd known these people forever. This story is the story I keep seeing again and again. It's about how private citizens, through their own initiative, out of love, out of compassion, out of their great heart, have opened up their homes and opened up their hearts. So, class of 2022, whether you're planning to go off to college or to trade school or to start your first job or to enlist in the military, or if you still don't know what's next, be thankful for the attitudes and be inspired by the actions of one another and of all the other knowledgeable, responsible people in Poland and around the world. In the next chapter of your journey, remember this wise advice from your classmates, and we know you'll be well equipped to meet the challenges and new experiences that will come your way."
need you to raise your glass. I don't care what you put in it. Here's to the nights that you can't take back. We live hard, but we love to laugh. We all thought that we'd get rich fast. Hop the plane out for greener gas. Thought out that the green is cash. Don't compare to the friends that last. See, we won't forget where we came from. The city won't change us. We beat to the same drum.
At this time, we'd like to recognize our honor graduates. The following students have earned the distinction of cum laude. They have earned a cumulative weighted GPA between 3.87 and 4.02 and are wearing the white cords this evening. Please hold your applause until we have read all the names. And please stand up as we read your name. Andrew Bilardo, Maxon Elliott, Sierra Foltz, Evan Harris, Ian Henry, Allison Mboden, Cordelia Jerkowski, Catherine Kepke, Dominic Maculone, Jessanna Meyer, Molly Nickus, Luke Othick, Jocelyn Reed, Gabriel Reynolds, Jenna Shadell, Kira Smith, Ariel West. Congratulations. Can you see that?
The following students have earned the distinction of magna cum laude. They've earned a cumulative weighted grade point average between 4.03 and 4.19. And I believe they're wearing the silver cords. Please hold your applause until I've read their names. And as I read your name, please stand. Aviana Avis, Kayla Bloom, Brendan Bromwell, Christopher Bruner, Malia Callahan, Seth Comfort, Hallie Ernst, Esther Gottlich, Laurel Gostomsky, Cassidy Hoipel, Madeline Kennish, Angelina Logan, John Long, Trevor Martin, Ashley McDonald, Madison Moore, Zachary Munsterman, Caitlin Neal, Richard Rankin III, Caitlin Rodriguez, Claire Starbuck, Janaea Thomas, Megan Wareham.
The following students have earned the distinction of summa cum laude. They have earned a cumulative weighted GPA of 4.20 and above and are wearing the gold cords tonight. Please stand as your name is read and hold your applause until the end. Olivia Burson, Marissa Casares, Jason Cho, Devin Cook, Jackson Deal, Haley Finifrock, Elsbeth Gladfelter, Allie Griffiths, Audrey Ermischer, Emma Kreisel, Todd Lancaster, Mary Catherine Land, Christian Lockard, Claire Kate Mallory, Brett Marnholtz, Casey McBride, Aiden McMurphy, Cooper Meldrum, Haley Merritt, Lakaya Moore, Landon Nakonesny, Amber Peterson, Jack Renfro, Abigail Richner, Isabella Salee, Jessica Snare, Justin Terrell, Aiden Walker, Hannah Walters, Tyler Ward, Macy Watson, Francis Whitbeck, Jordan Whitmire, Michelle Wu, Uming Wu, and Gavin Wyatt. Congratulations.
Well, we made it. Finally, we are here, ready to graduate. What a fascinating and also nerve-wracking thing this is. As most of you may already know, I'm Warren Short, and what an honor it is to be here in front of all you today. I know that I have learned my fair share of knowledge and lessons from my high school experience, and I'm sure you also have. So, I'm here today to share three takeaways from high school to carry with you throughout your lifetime. These three things are not worrying about what others will think of you, respect, and choosing wisely who you associate with. First, don't worry about what others will think of you. I know I used to worry about what people thought about me, and it used to always hold me back from what I would want to do or make me change how I would act. I've seen this happen so often in high school, and it's saddening. I'll ask you to never worry about what others will think of you. Whatever it is you want to do, go out and do it with everything you have. If anybody does judge, they're the ones in the wrong. Go out and be you and embrace the hell out of it. You won't regret it, and you will be pleased that you went out on that limb and that you did what you wanted or acted how you did. You will be a more genuine person by not worrying about others. You won't be held back and brought down by others' views and beliefs. Second, respect. This is something that you should give anyone, no matter who or what they are. It isn't optional, and you can't pick or choose who this is assigned to. Whether or not you like the person or side with what they believe in, you should give respect to them. Respect is not something that you just give others. It is something that you need to have for yourself. Without respect for yourself, you will never understand how you would expect people to treat you and what you hold yourself to. When you can respect others and yourself, you will be able to understand how you should act, what values you hold close to your heart, and that you don't need to bow down to how society holds itself. As a result, you will feel better as a person, have more confidence, and have genuine people surrounding you, lifting you up with anything you decide to do. Third, choose wisely who you associate with. This is one thing that I genuinely do believe that you can implement in your life every day, no matter what. I think this because anyone you hang around directly impacts how people perceive you or what situations you end up being in. It may not affect you right away, but it is always there, and it will usually always get you when you're least expecting it and in the worst times. So what do you do about this? If you haven't already, look around. Look and see who you're always hanging around with. Look and see how they act, what they stand for, and who they are as human beings. If it isn't a pleasant sight, then reach out and find some better people to associate with. Find people who will lift you up and help you, who will be there even in your lowest of lows, and people who appreciate who you are as your actual self. This may sound complicated and intimidating, but it is not. The right people will come into your life at the right time and for the right reasons. And when they do, you will know it, and they will too. So hold on tight and don't let go of them. These are the three most important things that I've learned from high school. Not to worry about what others will think of you, respect, and to choose wisely who you associate with. I hope what I have shared with all of you this evening meant something to you, and that you can take it and carry it with you in your life from now on. I wish all of you the best of happiness and success in your lives. It has been a pleasure growing up and maturing with every one of you. I know all of you will do great things in this world. Thank you for your time and attention.
This graduation, by and large, is the end of childhood for most of us. Sure, we may be freeloaders for a few more years, but at least now we'll have a little piece of paper that says, hey mom, I actually did something. 13, heck, 14 years of work is nothing to sneeze at, especially when you consider that that's more than 3/4 of our lives. Of course, looking back, it seems a little difficult to call kindergarten work, but to our minds, there was nothing more torturous than reading about the big red dog. You know the one. In those many years, a lot's changed. Anyone who's attended a family reunion will hear exactly how big they've gotten an ungodly amount of times. Seriously, I've considered handing out a flowchart just so I don't have to answer the same question over and over. Yet, though I knew exactly how old I was getting to be, I scarcely realized that all of my classmates were also growing up too. See, over the years, we've gone through a lot of emotional changes too. That's the most important part, honestly, because I don't think that I want someone who fought with me over a chicken Elmo toy to be the hope for the future. She knows who she is. And I'd like to think that I too have matured, because no matter how many times I apologize, I can't forget that my logical solution to not being able to play on the playground was to start throwing rocks at the classmate who was taking my favorite spot. She also knows who she is. Frankly though, I wish I'd gotten up to a little bit more shenanigans before police intervention would have been warranted. Anyway, we're older now, and hopefully with some better coping skills on our belts than throwing rocks. And with that, I will channel my inner grandma and impart some mad wisdom on you all with all the undeserved authority that only a teenager can offer. See, despite the deceit of motivational posters, you're not the best. Now for my classmates, this may be hard to hear. I mean, come on, you just had a party in your honor, right? Well, guess what? So did I. And so did the kid next to you. So you can't add up, we can't all be the coolest. Although I am standing while everyone else here is sitting, so take that how it is. But no, seriously, you will fail. Perhaps in high school you found your place in the world. You were the most talented painter, the fastest runner, or maybe you were known for being the bottomless pit of a person that could eat anything you were handed. There was something, no matter how small, that you were dang good at. But as we leave the safety of familiarity, things are bound to be different. And that was something I hadn't considered until I had the privilege of attending Missouri Girls State this last summer, just down the hall. Now, I'd like to consider myself to be a charismatic person, because otherwise this may be the worst speech that you ever heard. And I always thought I could think on my toes, but in the course of that week, I felt talentless. See, at MGS, every political office in their mock government is filled by a quick vote, and instead of running campaigns, you just get a little speech to say that why you're the best candidate for the position. And no matter how intelligently I phrased my case, every single time, I lost. For example, when I was running for treasurer, which I thought no one else would try to do, because who wants to be treasurer, really? I mentioned that that's what I was in NHS, because I had the same thought process for that. And somehow another girl followed me by saying that even though she wasn't the treasurer in NHS, she was the president, and she actually worked in her county's treasury office, which I didn't know a high schooler could do. And she was the president of DECA, the president of debate, and basically everything else I'd ever heard of. And so someone will always be better qualified than you. And if you're wondering, that girl actually lost somehow, even though she was probably better qualified to be the treasurer of the real county than anything. And she lost to a girl who said she liked pirates, and therefore treasurer. But that was the trend, because everyone was sick of hearing of everyone else's millions of accreditations. Because at Girl State, no matter how smart you were, somebody else was smarter. Such is life. As many of us transition into college and others into their careers, the reputations that we sculpted for ourselves in high school will be rendered null and void. This, my friends, is a chance to really prove yourself, going forth without expectations to fill. I encourage you to go forth unafraid of being second best. Know that no one will remember your mistakes any more than you remember theirs. And if you, as I always do, if you're listening at all, ignore the advice of dual speeches, by all means, carry on. You can tell me that how that worked out in our customary 10-year reunion, by which point I think we'll all have had enough time apart to finally get to appreciate each other. I kid, I appreciate you all now, and I must thank you, teachers and students alike, for the years we've shared together and the memories we've made. Catch you on the flip side.
This is an impossible thing to follow, but I've got the good news, so here we go. It's about that time. It is my honor and privilege to inform you that these members of the class of 2022 have met the graduation requirements as set forth by the Missouri Department of Elementary and Secondary Education, by the Board of Education of the Warrensburg R6 School District. I recommend to the Board of Education, to Board President Dr. Scott Chenault, and to the Superintendent of Schools Dr. Andy Cole, each of these 208 candidates be recognized as graduates from Warrensburg High School. Dr. Chenault and members of the Board of Education, I present to you the Warrensburg High School class of 2022.
Thank you, Dr. Pummel. And more importantly, congratulations to the senior class of 2022. On behalf of the Board of Education of the Warrensburg R6 School District, I am pleased to accept the 208 candidates for a diploma from Warrensburg High School as presented by Dr. Pummel. I also extend compliments to the entire faculty and staff of the district for their combined efforts in preparing the class for this important evening, and to parents and guardians who have supported them, and especially to the members of the class who have worked hard to meet the requirements for a high school diploma. Based on the recommendation of the high school principal, we can now proceed with the ceremony recognizing the individual members of the class of 2022.
Grace Ann Freedom Allen. McKenna Rose Anderson. Aviana May Avis. Jaron William Thomas Ball. Andrew Edward Bilardo. Angelica Lavinia Rose Bergeron. Kayla Elizabeth Bloom. Amber Grace Bogadane. Alexis Lorraine Bose. Brendan J. Bromwell. Cheyenne Faye Brown. Christopher Philip Bruner. Luke Alexander Burford. Bailey Cherie Burkhart. Olivia Catherine Burson. Noah Parker Caldwell. Jeremy Alexander Cayley. Malia Diane Callahan. Alyssa Hope Carpenter. Rochelle Leanne Carroll. Ryland Matthew Castaneda. James Maurice Collins. Seth Allen Comfort. Devin Rose Cook. Antonio Carlos Corona. Anastasia Marie McCord Crows. Katie Leanne Kroos. Amaya Marvette Daniels. Adrian Jace De Santiago. Jackson James Deal. Madison Patrice Dean. Caleb Andrew Dicely. Taryn Elizabeth DeVries. Dominique Nishe Dollar. Aviana Lauren Dortch. Riley Jean Dunn. Vince Chadrick Dunn. Cheyenne Marie Esquina. Maxon Drew Elliott. Hallie Rochelle Ernst. Althea Cassandra Estosa. Alexis Grace Edders. Anthony Wayman Fuel. Haley Nicole Fenefrock. Gavin Todd Fontaine. Lena Tafarez Francis. Mason John Fritch. Abigail Leona Fuston. Matthew Allen Gaddis. Daniel Monroe Guyberson. Kelly Suzanne Gilpin. Elsbeth Ivy Gladfelter. Adam Andrew Glazier. Esther Sabine Pilar Mado Cusage Gottlick. Paul Xavier Gonzalez. Ashton Ray Goodwin. Laurel Elizabeth Harmon Gostomski. Erica Shania Graves. Allie Grace Griffiths. Elena Joyce Gumatautau. Jaden Matthew Gunn. Brett Eric Hall. Evan Dennis Harris. Maricel Maylene Hart. Isaac Morgan Valentino Hayes Mora. Ian Keith Gonzalez Henry. Cassidy Michelle Hoipel. Macy May Hill. Sierra Marie Holliday. Lauren Nicole Holloway. J. Joey Simone Howe. Allison Sue Emboden. Audrey Morgan Ermisher. Andrew Eugene Jager. Mackenzie Shaylin Jeffrey. Landon Bryant Johnson. Dawson Michael Joyner. Trevor Austin Kelsey. Nolan William Kennedy. Madeline Rose Kennish. Jessica Lynn Kirksick. Peyton Anthony Kyrell. Kirsten Brianna Kohler. Catherine Michelle Kepke. Emma Leanne Kreisel. Todd Lynn Lancaster. Mary Catherine Rose Land. Kylie Michelle Leggett. Sarah Lucille Lynn. Mark David Lewis Jr. Parker Gregory Lightfoot. Christian John Lockard. Angelina Misaki Logan. John William Long. Helena Marie Lopez. Clara Kate Mallory. Madison Virginia Marksmeyer. Brett Ryan Marnholtz. Mackenzie Aline Martin. Trevor William Martin. Lundez Nehemiah McCall. Caleb Randall McConville. Ashley Jaden McDonald. Aiden Byron McMurphy. Cooper David Meldrum. Haley Nicole Merritt. Kiefer Allen Meiske. Finn Meyer. Jessana Helene Meyer. Trinity Nicole Miller. Elizabeth Marie Mobley. Lakaya Rochelle Moore. Madison Taylor Moore. Nicholas Michael Moore. Zachary Scott Munsterman. Garrett Sean Patrick Murphy. Anthony Logan Myers. Landon James Nekonesny. Kaylee Elaine Naren. Caitlin Jade Neal. Kaylin Marie Neville. Keegan Scott Newberry. Derek John Nickus. Molly Louise Nickus. Alana Loretta Osborne. Luke Daniel Authick. Jade Nicole Parrott. Joshua Alexander Parton. Chloe Grace Patterson. Reese Olivia Patterson. Amber Louise Peterson. Jimmy Ray Perry. Cambry Rebecca Peterson. Gabriel William Petrie. Sierra Don Pigman. Rachel Ann Prettyman. Andrew Ryan Price. Billy Joe Pruitt. Richard Carl Rankin III. Jocelyn Ann Reed. Jack Wolfgang Renfro. Gabriel Damon Reynolds. Evan Monroe Rice. Taylor Rain Rice. Abigail Evelyn Richner. John J. Reitbrock. Timothy James Riggs. Isaac Reed Robertson. Caitlin Michelle Rodriguez. Sophia Nicole Rodriguez. Isabella Bryn Salee. Matea Rochelle Shear. Bryce Matthew Schoonover. Jenna Ray Shadell. Colin Michael Scott. Benjamin Aaron Schaefer. Gabriel Hunter Schaefer. Damian Richard Shields. Olivia Margot Shively. Warner Jackson Short. Eric Austin Sixberry. Stacy Marquise Simmons Jr. Nicole Lynn Civils. Nathan James Scahan. Connor John Smith. Emma Claire Smith. Kira Pally Smith. Jessica Chrysostomo Snare. Lacey Olivia Stagner. Claire Janelle Starbuck. Spencer Craig Steinman. Nathan Gregory Stevens. Cassidy Lynn Tate. Jasmine Ashanti Taylor. Justin Don Terrell. Reese Joseph Tout. Janaea Thomas. Camden Lake Patrick Timler. Ryan Wyatt Trobaugh. Riley Alexander Vaughn. Aiden Ryan Walker. Hannah Renee Walters. Tyler Ronald Ward. Megan Brianne Wareham. Macy Ann Olivia Watson. Ariel Brittell West. Joshua Benjamin West. Kira Joanne West. Isabella Lauren White. Desiree Leovani Williams. Francis June Yan Whitbeck. Dylan Lee Whitmire. Jordan Adriana Birk Whitmire. Sarah Leanne Woodward. Michelle Wu. Yuming Wu. Gavin Allenton Lee Wyatt.
Well, congratulations, graduates, you made it! Go ahead and stand up for me. At this time, graduates, if you have not already done so, slide that tassel over to the left. I would officially like to welcome all 208 of you to a very distinguished group, the alumni of Warrensburg High School. Go ahead and sit down. While we bid you farewell and wish you the best as you accept your new challenges and begin new adventures, your journey is far from over. But while this chapter is closed, you're getting ready to start a new chapter of your story, and I know you will make us all proud. We would like to thank all who attended this evening and help make this a memorable evening for the graduates of 2022. At the end of the recessional, you may meet your graduate outside that entrance under the awning and meet them there. We do ask that you allow them to get all the way out of the building. Graduates, again, congratulations. Hang on. Good evening to all who attended, and please travel safely.